Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I begin a new section of my channel, Tricks and Tips for Machine Learning, where I will explain small things that you usually will find very useful when you are developing applications, machine learning applications, and you will see that there are small tricks to help you to build the to build the application. For example, how to check if your GPU is working correctly, how to set up the environment. These kind of things are most of the times more connected with Python development, but in many projects I need to do the same things, and then I find it that sometimes it's a little bit annoying. Find this stat or look in my documents how I did that and that, and then and then I think that you will find it interesting, and then it's not only for you, it's also for me to remember how I had to do many things at the time that I'm creating an application which later on is going to run in different environments, in Docker, in local, in the CI/CD pipeline, in the production environment. And then again, you will see that this is quite interesting, and how to do these small things that probably many people are just focusing in how to use this model, but at the end of the day, what you more usually use is all these small tricks to finally create the application and move the application toward into prod, no? And today I will just explain you how to do two things, two small things. What is how to set up your environment with a library that is .env. This library is going to work without problems in Windows and Unix environment. It doesn't matter if you are working on local, in a Docker, in the CI/CD pipeline. The library is pretty simple to use, and it's working, and then it's help you to define not only environment variables, also to keep your secrets. And this is also a best practice when you are developing applications that need to be deployed to different environments and running a component of a bigger pipeline, no? And then how I usually do is I create my .env file. I put it on a subfolder on my application. In this case, the application I'm building is document classification. If you are watching the other videos in my channel, you will see other videos related to that where I explain how to work with LangChain, but that's the topic of the other videos. Here I will just explain how I'm building the application and just these small tricks that help me to set up all the environment around the application. Again, I create a small file. The configuration of the file is pretty simple. It's just name of the variable equal to the value. Here, for example, we have an integer. Here we have an integer or boolean. This is one string. Here is the name of the transformer. Here is the type of the embedding I'm going to use. I define the environment. Here you can have also passwords, usernames, API keys, whatever you need, no? You keep it simple. Don't forget later to remove it from your Git ignore. Don't push it unless that you need in your CI/CD. For example, this file I will not exclude it, but if the file contain credentials, you should exclude it from your to be pushed to your repository. Okay, you set up your variables, and then on the file simply import the library, load environment, load OS as well, import the operating system library, and then on you set up the path of the file, you load it with the load underscore dot environment, and then this load in memory the file, and this is gonna work again in any environment: Windows, Docker, local Docker, in production, in Kubernetes, in your CI/CD pipeline, in the AGN when you are building or deploying the application to the different environments. This works everywhere. And then on here, as you see, you just get os.getEnvironment variable name, the same name that you have here, and you assign the value to your variables in the application. Here I'm doing just a print. Let's do a try, and later I will explain the second. Okay, as you see here, we print all these variables with the values that you set out on your file. The second is where I am. This is many times when you when you are working and building different different components, and then these components, as in my case, work well. I tried it. I developed it local, as you see here. I'm developing with remote development components into Windows or System Linux. My setup is a Windows machine, but I developed in Unix, in Linux, because most of the applications work well in production. They are gonna work in Linux as well, so it's better to have your environment, your local environment, as close as possible as your production one. And then on these applications, all of them run in Docker, works with the fast API. And then, well, many times it's important to know where you are in order to localize files inside the application, like in this case, no? And then on, you need to know what is the root of the application, and regardless if the application is in the Docker in your local environment, if the application is being built in the CI/CD pipeline, or is working in a Kubernetes or a VN in production, or whatever the application is, no? And then to know where the, for example, this file is, you just need to do something like that. This is telling you what is the path of the file. And then if you see here, what we are going to assign to root underscore dir is the location of this file, the relative position of this file versus the folder that is the root of your application. Later, when I deploy this to production, as you can see here, I also have my Docker file here, and also my fast API endpoint. So when you later deploy this into the Docker, using this variable, you always know where your file, your endpoint, for example, file is, and you can make reference to other files as you know where is the root of the application. This is gonna work in Windows, this is gonna work in Unix, is operating system agnostic, and this way you later on can deploy with confidence that the application, regardless where it was developed, is gonna work without any problem, and you are going to find the files, and you can make a reference to folders, output folders, input folders, files, whatever you need, no? So here we set up the root of the application, and then again is this the location of these files related to this folder, to the folder where I had the application, all the files and input info of the application, environment variables, whatever you had in your application. And then on here I'm just using the path join to point to a folder. This is where I had the data. In this case, I pointed to this folder data where I had a CSV, and here I point to a CSV file where I had some information, and here I just simply read it with pandas. No? Let me do a try in order to show you what we had. And as you can see here, rootit is the path of the application. Again, if you are working in Windows, this is going to give you a Linux path, but this because the OS path class is giving you as well, regardless the operating system, is operating system agnostic. Here we had the path of the file, and here we had the two first rows of the CSV file. Okay, that's all. I hope you like it. If you like it, just you know what you need to do. Give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you. See you soon.